I'm Jamie McDonald. Join me as we celebrate small businesses that make New York so unique. These New York Originals. The Grand Prospect Hall, an event space for countless weddings, parties, even movie productions. It is one of the last Victorian ballrooms left in America, but it almost didn't make it into the 21st century. Now, thanks to a couple of loving caretakers, this Grand Dam is ready for a close-up.
Walking by the Grand Prospect Hall, one might not first appreciate its elegance. For like a Fabergé egg, its outside gives just a preview of the opulence inside. Amazingly, the building sat derelict for years before Michael and Alice Halkias brought it back to life, making it one of the premier banquet halls of New York City.
When you walk into that ballroom and know that 1,500 people fit comfortably in such a facility, and that's only one floor. There's four floors to this building. There's 16 different rooms in this building. And, you know, every single room has its own identity.
Grand Prospect Hall was opened in 1903, replacing the original one built in 1892 after it had been destroyed by fire. Builders were determined to make it bigger and better than before, something to rival the gilded mansions of Park Slope. It was designed in a French Renaissance motif inspired by France's Palace of Versailles. From top to bottom, the hall is adorned with ornate designs, bright color schemes, and gold leaf. The hall also boasts a series of Brooklyn firsts. Not only was it once the tallest building, but also the first electrified commercial building and the first to have a passenger elevator. It was even equipped with a bowling alley, billiard hall, and a shooting gallery. But its centerpiece has always been the Grand Ballroom. With its 40-foot high ceiling and two-tiered balcony, it holds well over 1,000 people. Once open for business, Grand Prospect Hall quickly became the premier Victorian community center. Opera, ballroom dances, vaudeville shows, and movies packed them in on a daily basis. Performers included Mae West, Bob Hope, Ginger Rogers, and Fred Astaire. Lena Horne got her professional start here as a teenager. Political events were also popular. William James Bryant and William Randolph Hearst gave presidential campaign speeches here. And in 1914, the Women's Suffrage Party kicked off its national campaign at the hall. And crime boss Al Capone was said to have frequented here, attending operas staged in the ballroom. Capone was a sign of things to come, for the building would later become a mob hangout, among other things.
The top floor was a Polish school, originally. Then it became where monks used to pray and make illegal beer for the mob.
As the years wore on, the hall fell into a steady decline. At one point, owners of the hall even began selling off fixtures to keep afloat. Then in 1981, the Halakiases arrived, becoming just the third owners.
This building was dilapidated. It was unoccupied for over 12 years. There was no ceilings left. There was just dilapidation, holes in the ceilings, no balconies, puddles of buckets of water. When he took this building over, and it took him almost 12 years, even before he opened up a door.
The restoration revealed several forgotten treasures, like these whimsical paintings covered for decades in layers of black paint. One is a caricature of President Theodore Roosevelt, though Teddy might not be too flattered, for his rump is painted facing forward. The restoration was only the beginning, for the owners are still to this day tracking down fixtures that were sold off. That commitment was rewarded in 1999 when the Grand Prospect Hall earned National Landmark status from the federal government. Today, the hall is back and better than ever. On busy weeks, there are some 20-plus events here, which include office parties, dance competitions, and anniversaries, among other things. Hollywood has also come calling, using the Grand Prospect in several commercials, music videos, and motion pictures. Among them, The Cotton Club, The Royal Tenenbaums, and Pritzi's Honor, starring Jack Nicholson. But their bread and butter are, of course, weddings.
They are ecstatic. The people, especially dealing with a lot of brides, they leave and they feel that this is the dream come true building. I just had a bride the other day. She got married 25 years ago. And she says people are still talking about this, the wedding.
Not surprising, for the Grand Prospect Hall, throughout its century-plus life, has always been unforgettable.
Well, it shouldn't be work, really. It's work, but that's not how we look at things. It's just the responsibility, and it's the duty. And it just happens that we enjoy to do successfully what we do. We could very well be someplace else, in a mountain or in a sunny place in a beach. We have no problem with that. But our job and our commitment to this place is total.
Now, if you're thinking about hosting an event at the Grand Prospect Hall, they have a website that's very comprehensive that includes everything from floor plans to menu options.